Thank you. 边滚的和辣椒，我要吃鸡汤，这个酱都不吃。自己吃饭前我最记得，那年我挣到点钱，喝起下地吃饭前不一夜，放着嘴巴前不多久，那一天只摘一根根针，等起空儿去安静。当天早上问个拉索拉，给别走廊的做亲戚了，前方我挣到点饭了，都没忘到这边我这坐着。妈我是最近打扰我个不平的给公司做了多不一起的我给公司没了心的都给你妈弄啊进入就是跟妈妈他一多解决你跟我学自己的车看来家人滚天高我见了老夫和妈妈这些人上一些慢着玩了和你就不会接受的真的哪里解决一种旅行啊就是想念我去看看房子都接花文宅给做那当年买金不买年给一片地出自由都能空空下去看看多少马鞭困得用来叫我自己当这样想都不认识自己吃饭前我推进了那年我挣到点钱喝起下去吃饭前不一夜放着嘴巴前不多久那一天只摘一根根针等地空完血安静了当天早上问个拉索拉给别个
我的鞋边我这坐着
Dear friends, Dhamma brothers and sisters, good evening and happy new year. My name is Tiffany and I'm the translator and host for today's teaching. We're so privileged to have the Venerable Kenpo Sodaji Rinpoche to be here with us at Wisdom and Compassion Dhamma University on the first day of 2017. How lucky we are. In Buddhism, we talk about dependent origination.And I also heard in Tibet, people take the first day as the most important and auspicious because it's the first day of the new year. Therefore, it's even more auspicious that we gather together and listen to Rinpoche's teaching on this special day. So in today's agenda, Rinpoche will be giving Dharma teaching on approaching the guru first. After that, Rinpoche will be distributing some free gifts.This gift is not money or gold or anything like that. It is the oral transmission of the noble gold-like Mahayana Sutra. Okay, now let's welcome Rinpoche to give us the teaching. <笑>各位现场以及网络的朋友们，大家晚上好，新年快乐。我是今天的主持人，我的名字叫 Tiffany。今天是2017年的第一天，很高兴能够在这个特殊的日子里和大家和上师仁波切在智悲弘法大学这个空中殿堂相聚。听说在藏地有这样一个传统，人们把新年伊始当作为一年的缘起，而在所有的缘起当中，我们因为由于善法而产生连接，实在是最为殊胜的。今天上师仁波切将和我们聊聊上师与弟子之间的种种迷思，仁波切还非常贴心地为大家准备了特殊的新年贺礼，他将在开示之后为我们传授圣大乘金子经的传承。那对于海外的观众来说呢，我今天将担任大家的英文翻译。好了，那话不多说，现在有请仁波切为我们开示如何医治善知识，有请仁波切。
这种动作是藏地很多大卦的时候用这样的。
What Rinpoche is doing now is very popular in Tibet. People normally do that when they go to a master and want the master to make a mold.
我在大卦，我今天降的怎么样？
I'm doing that because I want to know what my speech will be like today.
开玩笑，我刚刚。
I'm just kidding.
啊，这样的，今天，2017年的第一天，跟大家，一起在，特殊的， 殿堂里，以比较特殊的方式，大家一起祭聚啊，姻缘非常殊胜，也特别感谢大家空出非常宝贵的时间，来倾听，我觉得我们新的一年当中，大家有共同学习的机会是非常难能可贵的。
First, Rinpoche said he is very happy to gather together with everybody here today, and he thinks it's such a great opportunity to be here and study and learn together. And second, he wants to thank everyone who participate tonight, and thank you for your time. Rinpoche said in this new year, 2017, we can keep on studying and learning.
今天我们学习如何一知三知识的这个话题呢，我用汉语讲，然后用英文翻译。这个过程当中，如果懂得双语的人呢，可能觉得有兴趣。我讲的什么他翻译的对不对，或者是这样的。但是只懂一种语言不懂第二种语言的人呢，也许可能中间会打瞌睡，睡着。如果你睡着了的话，我提前就跟你说一句晚安。
Today, Rinpoche wants to engage a topic approaching the guru, and he will be giving the teaching in Chinese, and I will be translating from Chinese into English. So those who understand both Chinese and English, you guys will know if I'm translating correct or incorrect. But if you don't understand English, you may fall asleep. For people like that, I want to say good night.
今天我们听众当中，大多数是佛教徒，也有一些不是佛教徒的。那么，我可能今天着重讲一些佛教的医治方式，医治善知识的方式。在这个时候呢，你也可以，从另一个角度来，了解到，到底是怎样，医治自己的善知识。如果这样医治的话呢，他会获得什么？你也希望引起你的思考。
Today, I understand some of the audience are Buddhist and some of them are non-Buddhist. Today, my teaching the teaching will be in regards of approaching the guru from the Buddhism's perspective. I will be talking about how to rely a spiritual master. So those non-Buddhists, I hope you can gain some benefit out of this topic.
我今天讲的有几点啊。首先第一点呢，我想说一下我们现在的状况。也就是说，在这个时代当中，人们都依靠自己的努力，在物质财富上面得到一定的满足，但是在内心的追求方面还比较空虚，甚至有些是很苍白。在这样的时候，人们都拼命的追求内心的安乐，同时也寻找许多的心灵导师。
Nowadays, people are abundant with material lives, and they pursue this material life wholeheartedly, and they work really hard to make money. However, we need to face a situation that people do lack of the guidance in terms of spiritual practice. So it's quite common for us to seek a spiritual teacher or a spiritual guru nowadays.
我记得2015年的时候美国有一个报道美国现在追求心灵的这种瑜伽的人呢有2300万人左右。那么他们把所谓的瑜伽有关的一系列的这些知识呢就是成为一个禅语。那么甚至已经到达了93美银就是三亿美金就是3亿美金。那么从中也可以看出来就是西方发达的国家他们也拼命追求的内心拼命的追求内心的世界。
According to a report back in 2015,The number of people who practice yoga in America has reached to a number of 23 billion. And yoga as a whole industry has gained a profit of 9.3 billion American dollars. So from this statistics, we can tell that even in some of the Western countries, people do need spiritual guidance.
也就是2016年8月份的时候呢有一个报道也是新京都报道新京报的这么一个资料当中显示说是有一个非法机制他帮这个心灵培训他是以结合心理学成功学还有很多的包括一些心灵鸡汤的一些知识大量的收集一些他们的所谓的弟子有些是交了50000块钱有些是交了800万中共他的这种财富已经到达10多亿人民币所以从中我们可以看出来在这个时代当中人们特别追求内心当中找到了自己的快乐
There's another data back in 8 August this year. There's a news from Beijing News in August. It reported that there is an organization, it collects money illegally by providing workshops or some online courses to its members by charging a huge amount of money ranging from $50,000 to $8 million. And this organization has successfully gained the benefit of $10 billion. So from these statistics, we can also tell that people do need some help in regards of spirituality.
这是我讲的第一点现状。那么第二点呢我想讲现在很多追求善知识的一种内心每个人的内心都不相同的也有正面的一些内心也有反面的一些内心那么正面的这些内背的话呢就我们曾经很多人学过菩提道次第论的一致善知识当中呢像大地一样的内心还有像仆人一样的内心还有像金刚一样的就是在一致的过程当中呢自己心永远都是非常的坚固的就不会变化的就是有这么注重内心的弟子这样也是非常多的。
So the second point I want to discuss with you is the type of disciples nowadays. There are different type of disciples. There are good ones and the bad ones. If you learned the teaching of Larum, it talk about some good disciples. That when they rely their spiritual masters, their heart is as hard as the ground, or as faithful as a servant or as hard as a verger. So the faith on the spiritual teacher is very firm and the confidence is unshakable.
那么下面我从现在，结合现在的时机呢，可能很多人喜欢的一些上市啊，但是真正的三知识可能还有一定的距离。那么这种弟子的内心呢，首先有一种内心叫做最新型，就是也就是说时间当中就是有很多追求这个明性个性啊，就包括求性的，就是这么一个最新住。同样的，我们佛教界当中呢，也有很多人对某个上师产生一种不公的心性的时候呢，感觉到就是这个上师是显得特别的庄严呐、啊，就是这个上师特别帅啊，这个上师非常身体是胖胖的、啊，或者是身体是瘦瘦的啊，因为每个众生的业力都不相同的，所以呢，很多人是像没有更多的这些道理，但是呢，他特别就是喜欢这个上师的各种，包括一些表情啊、微笑啊，或者说是他的这个一切的这种。这个心诸作我的行为呢，就是对他已经有吸引着了，就是有这么一群人，就是这叫做是最新型。
So the first type of disciple I want to talk about is those ones who regard their spiritual teacher as a superstar. So when they rely on a spiritual teacher, they only consider if the teacher have a good looking or if he is masculine or if his expression is good. So normally these type of disciples are attracted by the master's expression and behaviors. So we regard this type of disciple as a disciple who regard their teacher as a superstar.
第二种心呢，就叫做是缺爱心，也就是说，有些人没有安全感，把上师当作父亲，当作母亲，或者是甚至，把上师当作自己的这种家属，比如说有些男性的这个弟子呢，就是对女性的上师就是特别崇拜，一些女性的弟子呢。就跟一些这个男性上师呢，就是也把他当作一种在自己的生活当中的伴侣，在生活当中的依靠处。他所追求的呢，并不是使从上师的智慧啊、悲心啊，或者说是其他的一些出世间的智慧，只是在他的生活当中，就是需要有一种安全感。就是那么这样的话呢，他的追求的目标呢，就是并不是是获得解脱，就应该是，就因为他缺少在生活当中缺少爱，缺少可靠的，缺少一种依附，在这种情况下，他为了满足自己的心理的空缺，把上师呢，就是自己，生活当中的最重要的一个人。
And the second type of disciple is those ones who need some emotional support from someone else. So they find a teacher and rely or take refuge on this teacher, but take the spiritual teacher as their lover or their father or their brothers. This motivation is quite wrong. So we can normally see when somemale disciples, they are easily attracted by the female masters. On the other hand, the female disciples are attracted by the male masters. So this type of disciples are seeking a sense of security from the spiritual teachers. However, the motivation is totally wrong.
第三种内心呢，是教义性。也就是把上师当作一种工具，需要八卦的时候用一用，需要看病的时候用一用，需要交年金钱的时候用一用，等等，在生活当中偶尔就是需要用他来合作的时候呢，他通过电话，通过微信，通过一种方式来，就是说 我现在需要做这样的这个事情啊，包括给我做什么佛事啊，给我做什么加持啊，就这样啊，就这也是它有一定的适用性，就互相都有一种适用性，反正是应该就像我们实践当中的从佛教方面的一种工作人员，就是以这样的一种方式来一直尝试。
The third type of disciple, we call them a trade-off type. They only go to the teachers, go to see the teachers when they need some help, whether it be their families or their personal life or their work life. So this motivation is wrong as well, because they only use the master as a tool to help them in terms of their personal life. So this is not the right motivation.
第四种呢，就是叫泡泡型，我们经常说的泡泡趋势，他可能不会很好的去在某个上师那里求一些正法，好好的修行。就像蜜蜂。到不同的画里面，就是吸它的这种画质，然后有费作了。其实这是在佛教当中有时候也是开虚的，但是如果去一直以为上师有抛弃它，有诽谤它，然后又到另外一个道场，另外一个上师就不断的换，就是最后自己也抛得特别累，晕头转向，最后自己也一无所获，也有这样一直的人。
The fourth type of disciple is those ones who are running around, and we call them run around late practitioners. Those run around practitioners, they go to different Dharma centers. Here I want to use a metaphor. They like a bee. They go to different flowers and then fly away.They keep on changing different teachers from one to another. So they, even though they keep on running around, but they will gain nothing in the end. So there's no benefit to them at all.
第六种类型呢，我有时候说的是花费类型，就是很多人可能看过这个《甄嬛传》，《甄嬛传》里面有一个叫做花费娘娘，她经常。就对自己的其他的妃子呢产生一个特别大的嫉妒心，性格比较蛮横。但我们有些弟子呢，为了获得上师的督促，获得了他的特别的这种加持和开悟，所以呢跟其他的任何的一些佛教徒呢不愿意接近，以通过种种方式来排除其他相关的这个弟子，而自己呢很想在上师的作用维护上师弘扬佛法。
The fifth type or the sixth type is Emperor's 华妃。So for those Dharma friends overseas, you may not know Hua Fei. She is a character in a TV drama called Empress in the Palace. So the character of Hua Fei is that he is he's a very hard person, and he holds strong hatred and aversion to other princes in the palace. So.This type of disciples that we talk about, he wants to, he thinks that the spiritual master belongs to himself or herself only. So whenever other practitioners or Dharma friends, they receive teachings or blessing from the guru or spiritual teachers, she or he will be,resentful.
第七种呢，有叫权贵性，也就是说， 把上市的所有的政治、经济、学习、生活全部都自己一个人控制起来，让上市呢除了自己吃饭睡觉以外没有很多的权利，就尤其是一些大事主、一些大的有一些比较权威的这个弟子身边的这个上师呢，感觉起来比较孤独，比较不自在。很多事情要看弟子的面，就所以他从方方面面就是把这个上师的所有的一些，包括对外交关系啊，就是对很多的一些事情呢，都就掌控，就是掌握的比较全面。然后让上师呢在可以试用的时候可以出场，就是除此之外呢都权力都比较微妙。也有这样。
The seventh type of disciple is those types we called authority type. They control the life of the gurus. So this type of disciples is normally those ones who are the great benefactors in a Buddhist community, and they control the life of the gurus in whether it be going out to giving the Dharma teachings or to meet someone else. They all want to intervene with the guru's life. So this is not the right motivation either.
第八种类型呢，毒药性，就是比如说这个吃毒药的话呢，都会生病的。那么这种弟子呢，他跟不管是自己的上师跟别的上师都经常去诽谤，经常造过失，经常背后或者是当面呢就是宣传一些上师有和没有的负面的一些情况。那么很多人借助他都比较可怕，这个人对谁都会诽谤。因此这样的弟子的话呢，就是他也是他的专业是依靠这种诽谤啊，寻找过失啊，就经常就说自己的功德，说上师的过失，就是那么这个也是非常可怕的，可能借助谁都会不同程度的染上一定的这种就痛苦，或者说是就不好的这种结果。
The next type is poisonous type. This type of disciple are those ones who slander their gurus, because after they rely on a guru and they find out that this is not my root guru and he's not perfect, so turn around he or she become quite harsh towards the guru's dharma activities or other activities. It's very terrifying because this type of disciples are very specialized in finding other people's fault, whether it be their friends or their gurus. However, they praise themselves, so we call it a poisonous type.
第九个类型呢叫上帝性。就按照这个有些宗教的说法，上帝是万能的，所以有些弟子呢把上师当作今世来世的一切的依托者，自己不用修行，全是依靠上师的加持、威力、功德来获得今生来世的一切快乐。实际上呢，佛陀告诉我们，我给你开始解脱道，解脱的方便法，解脱依赖于自己，应该作为弟子自己啊去如理如法的闻思修行。可是有些人呢，我已经移植了上师，一切都是拜托你了，也有这样。
The next type is the God type. This type of disciples think that the guru can do everything for them, because we know in Western religions, in Christianity, God is almighty. So these type of disciples think that the guru can liberate for themselves and they don't have to do anything. This is quite wrong, because as it says in the sutra by the Buddha himself, the virtuous men, I can only explain and show you the way to liberation. However, you need to practice diligently yourself in order to liberate yourself.
医生这九种类型的话呢，主要是阐述着一些负面上的一些弟子的状况啊。也许我们有个别人呢，从中找到自己的影子。不管怎么样呢，其实我们不能如理如实的寻找上师呢，实际上我们可能还没有认识到佛教当中的所谓的上师呢，实际上是给我们开始真正的一些解脱道的，就是这么一个三知识。
The different types of disciples that we talk about, we can relate ourselves from those different from different type of disciples, and we know that the motivation is very wrong, because according to the sutras, we know that the right motivation to rely on a guru is to liberate ourselves from samsara.
如果我们没有找到真正的善知识，或者说我们的目标没有明确的话呢，可能很多人找这个机会来暂时满足你的一些需求，因为你需要的不是解脱，你需要的暂时的一些心灵的压力，生活当中的痛苦，或者感情上的一些折磨等等。在这个时候呢，我们可能很有必要就是观察内心，你为什么是一知善知识。几年前吧，有一个纪录片，它里面讲的是一个驾乘者的真实故事。实际上是一个美国人拍的。他是这个印度的后裔，就他当时看到就是美国很多人追求这个心灵的这种瑜伽士，但是很多瑜伽士并不是很专业的，就有些人是依靠这种种种外在的一些形象或者说包装来满足一些人，所以他当时自己呢就是进去扮演一个角色。
So we talk about the nine types of disciples, and then we know that that motivations are wrong. And on our path to liberation, if our motivation is wrong, we may be trapped or misled by other fake spiritual masters. So we need to understand why we need a guru and why we rely on a guru. So here I want to talk about a real story. It's called a true story of a fake masters. It is about a story from a filmmaker, an American filmmaker. He's actually an Indian descendant. He noticed a really interesting trend in America that a lot of people are getting interested in practicing yoga. However, yoga practitioners are very attracted by a so-called master who look like a spiritual teachers. The spiritual teachers may dress like someone with long hair or full of bears on their face. However, he think that this is the face that people pursue blindly. So he decided to create a figure to explain what is a real teacher.
当时他自己扮演成一个真正的印度的瑜伽师，有着他长长的头发，我以前看过这个纪录片，长长的头发，满面都是胡须，然后他会懂得一些他以前奶奶的一些印度的口音，然后他是，其实他是一个完全是一个试探性的，就是他测试，就是自己当一个瑜伽师怎么样，然后他在各个不同的地方，就是找一些瑜伽老师，就是学了一些，然后讲瑜伽，瑜伽讲的时候呢，就是特别成功，很多人，因为他自己知道自己不是瑜伽师，也不是印度人，但是呢。他当时去各个地方去摄受弟子的时候，弟子越来越多了，最后他也是暂时一直给他们讲一些先线上的一些瑜伽的课，到了最后他就有一次在视频上就是说，我不是瑜伽师，我不是印度人，我是美国人，他把自己的真相说出来了，当他说出来的时候，很多弟子特别的伤心，很失望，有些弟子比较能接受，有些弟子呢他就有一些引起思考，其实现在寻找心理老师的时候呢，可能有些老师他自己也知道是自己都不具足这个资格，而弟子的话呢可能会盲目的这个追求，结果呢就是师徒两者都是在从中拔不出来，其实这是也可以我们值得思考，也值得看一看想一想。
So he decided to create a figure, and this figure is called Kumari, and he dressed like an Indian yogi with really long hair, dressed a robe on his body, and he even mimicked his grandmother's Indian accent. So gradually he attracted a lot of yoga practitioners and a lot of followers.And as the number of his followers increasing, and he decided to tell everybody the truth. So he filmed a video. In his video, he told everybody that he's not a real yoga teacher. He is a real American, because in the film, he dressed like a Native American with short hair,a very fluent English. So what he wants to tell everybody is that we need to examine the teacher before we rely on them, or before we take refuge on them. A lot of the followers are very sad or disappointed after he told everybody the truth. However, there are some other people who understand his behaviors. Also, there are other people start to reflect what is a true spiritual teacher and what's the quality of the spiritual teachers.
他的当时电影得到了电影界的最佳奖，他当时用的是印度的叫司马伦，以后你们也可以演这样的角色。Samari, 刚才不是你说了。
So his film is very successful and is rewarded, is awarded in American film industry. And if you want to watch this video, you can search online the character that he created, his name is Kumari. I just said that.
这是第二一点，第三一点呢，我要讲一下一至三智社的动机。因为很多人可能刚才讲了，就是一至三智社它有可能暂时的一种目标，但实际上应该是获得长远的解脱，并不是贪求我们短暂的心事。这就是佛教的最主要的这个心理的祈求三智士的最好的动机。
And next I want to talk about the motivation, the right motivation to approach or rely on a guru. There are different types, the different types of motivation. So we talked about the 9 types of disciples. They rely on the master because they want to seek temporary comfort. However, this is not the long-term. This is not the long-term goal for a Dharma practitioner. As a Buddhist or Dharma practitioners, we need to seek liberation as our goal to rely a spiritual teacher.
这一点呢，我们这个一至三知识的主要的目标是解脱的。这一点藏传佛教有一个非常著名的教言，叫做《尼斯坦》。尼斯坦当中就是说，如果贪执精神呢，不是真正的修行人；如果贪执轮回呢，他没有出离心。从中可以看出来，真正的修行人呢，他想获得解脱，让在自信当中让升起真正的就是出离心。
So the real practitioners, their goal, their motivation to rely on a spiritual teacher is to liberate themselves from samsara. And here I want to use a teaching from Sakya school. It's called Parting from the Four Attachments. It's said that if you are clinging to this current life, you are not a real practitioner. If you are attached to samsara, you don't have any renunciation. So a real Buddhist practitioner should give up the current life and seek for liberation themselves.
以前中东吧尊者啊，他也是在拉章寺的时候，他经常有一些人请他去讲法的时候呢，他都并没有答应，让他的弟子去做的。而且他自己经常有一句话，就是说是我是希求解脱者，莫为弥养弥养父，就我们经常用过这样。所以一般真正的善知识呢，他不会被世间八法所染。
The venerable Tsongtongpa or Master Tsongtongpa, when he was practicing in his monastery, he was invited by some practitioners to go out to give the Dharma teaching. However, he normally refused to go out, and instead he wanted his disciple to go and give the teaching. And he keep on saying that he's a real Dharma practitioner, and he will not be attracted by this 8 worldly concern. So the real Dharma practitioners are those ones who are not trapped by the worldly concern at all.
第四一点，我要想讲一下一至三知识的重要性。大家都知道，我们实践当中的任何的唱歌、跳舞、学电脑、开车，甚至我们可能旅行，比如说你爬一个非常著名的山的话，如果没有一个很好的向导的话呢，怎么样爬山你不一定知道。其实你爬了山，但是路上有没有什么危险？山顶虽然看得到，就是非常美好的这种风景，但是你让到达这个目的地的话呢，心里没有安全感。有了这些一系列的这样的所谓的导师和引导者的话呢，你才可以掌握就是这个知识，或者是你能到达你的目标。
Next, I want to talk about the importance of a spiritual masters. Our spiritual masters are very important. I want to use 2 examples that we all know or we all understand. The spiritual master is like a teacher that teach us knowledge. For example, we need a teacher to learn new things, whether it be to learn how to sing or learn how to dance. A teacher is very important. And the next example is a travel guide when we are traveling. For example, when we are climbing, when we climb a mountain, we need to have a travel guide, because he or she will let us know what is the pathway to get up to the top of the mountain, how to go up to the mountain, and what's the shortcut to go up to the mountain. So by learning the worldly knowledge, we need a teacher, let alone the spiritual teacher on our path to liberation.
追求佛教的话呢，就是更不用说了，因为佛教是特别的高深和广大。记得《华严经》当中有一句话，叫做是“譬如暗中宝，无灯不可见，佛法无忍数，社会无能量，社会不能量。”意思就是说，前年黑暗的这个无事里面，如果有一个珍宝，就没有灯见不到的。同样的道理，虽然有些人就是有智慧的，但是呢，没有人讲经说法，没有人把这个佛法的道理给你开示的话，通过自学，依靠自己看本书啊，自己去了解一下，在寺院里面去自己就翻翻书啊，或者说是侧面了解的话呢，真正的佛法的一些渐修果的道理啊，就是渐修行果的道理呢，渐修行果会翻吧。没问题吧？渐修行果的道理呢，他也没说会，也不是不会，比较聪明，就很难懂到。就所以我们在佛教当中呢，就是一知善知识就是非常重要。如果没有善知识的开导的话，那实践的知识也不能通达，更何况说佛教的深奥意义。
Here I want to use a sutra to illustrate the importance of a spiritual teacher. In Avasaka Sutra, it says that without a light or a lamp, we can't see the treasure in the darkness. Likewise, without the spiritual teacher, we are not able to know the real meaning of the Buddha Dharma, because it is so vast and profound. So a spiritual teacher is very important. It shows us the right way to liberation, and it shows us how to study and contemplate and practice. So by relying a spiritual teacher, we will know what is the right view and how to practice and how to attainthe realization that we are aiming for.
还有一个重要性，阿含经，阿含经里面有一段，当时，佛陀在一个地方的时候呢，应该是在释迦故，在那个地方的时候，就阿难尊者就过来跟佛陀。其实是我发现一个非常重要的问题，是什么呢？在我们这个佛教当中，这个一知三知识呢，就是非常的重要，就是至少这个佛教的这个重要性的占一半。那么依靠一知三知识，与三知识结伴，与三知识相处的话呢，很有意义的。当时佛陀纠正他的话，就是说是你说重要的一半那么重要，这种说法是不对的。在佛教当中是佛教的全部，也就是说是方方面面都一知三知识都已经这个涉及到，所以一知三知识 和一三知识交往，一三知识相处呢，实际上是佛教的全部。这说明呢，我们在修行过程当中都需要上师的教言，上师的这种智慧和慈悲的这种摄受，有了他的话呢，我们的这个修行呢会三十三中。
In another sutra called Agama Sutra, it is actually a conversation between Buddha himself and his disciple Ananda. One day Ananda said, I realized that on our path to liberation, the spiritual teacher actually plays partial role on our path to liberation. And however, Buddha said, that's not right, Ananda. On our path to liberation, the spiritual teacher plays a very important role, almost the whole part. And it is true that we need the blessing from the guru, and the guru shows us the way to liberation and how to practice, and by assimilating the teaching, we can arise compassion or bodhicitta in our mind.
这个三知识的这一段段呢，在藏文当中是它专门叫做一至三知识经，就汉文当中好像设在这个阿含经里面。
In Tibet, the Agama Sutra is actually part of the Tipitaka, and in Tibetan Tipitaka, it is actually called how to rely on a spiritual guru sutra.
这是第四点吧。第五点呢，我也想讲这个。这样的善知识要值得观察，也就是说，首先你还没有接上上师和弟子之间的关系之前呢，通过各种不同的途径来了解，这个上师具不具足上师的法相、上师的条件，应该需要观察。梁万生大师也说过，如果这个上师没有，弟子没有观察上师，就像喝毒药一样的，就弟上师没有观察弟子呢，实际上是和什么就是跳崖一样的。那么上师也是在某种意义上观察弟子，可能我们现在现众的很多这个弟子呢，就是在传法过程当中的时候，谁都可以接受，然后在迷中的非常深深的一些意义给上师。上师如果给弟子要传授的话呢，实际上要靠后。我们现在，比如说讲密宗的很深的大圆满的法呢，就是能不能听，就是看这个弟子，怎么样呢？就是通过这个修无始顽加性来做这个试用期，就是然后到时候这个靠后，就是目标已经这个过了的话呢，就是就可以让他听。如果在医治过程当中，他的这种难度性啊，他的真诚性啊，就是不太足够的话呢，可能中间会退的。其实我觉得是，修无始顽加性呢，在某种意义上面是，这个上师观察弟子的也是一个考核标准。
The next point I want to say is we need to spend some time to examine the spiritual teacher. Before we rely on a spiritual teacher, we really need to observe their actions or behavior in order to make sure that this teacher is a qualified teacher. As Padmasambhava said, if the disciple do not examine the teacher, it is like drinking the poisoned water. Likewise, if the disciple do not examine the master, it is like jumping from the cliff. So in both Sutrayana and Tantrayana, we all have different ways to observe or examine the teacher or disciples. So in Tantrayana, we have the five preliminary practice. So this is a really good way for the masters to examine the disciples. So these five preliminary practice is likened, Rinpoche said, is likened to a probation period in our work life. So if the disciple gives up the practice in the process, it proves that the confidence on the guru or the confidence to liberate himself is not that strong. So this preliminary practice is a really good way for the masters to know if the disciple is has strong confidence in liberation.
观察上师呢，其实很重要。有些人没有了解上师，就先去听法，先去树观定，先去依止皈依等等，到最后去观察他的过失，这样不太合理。首先是应该自己去观察，就像我们实践当中寻找一个合作单位，合作的一些工作人。合作一个人，那么跟他交往之前的话呢，就肯定要了解就是他的社会背景，他个人的身份等等方方面面，然后你再可以跟他签协议签合同。同样的道理，我们实际上首先这个上市就合不合格，就是做一系列的测试，一系列的观察，通过不同方式来就是了解这个他真正是不是有智慧，能不能满足我从轮回当中获得解脱，或者是我需要暂时的心灵的这种痛苦，他依靠他的智慧和能力修行来解决。这至少也是我们对每个上师呢，就是你所依止的这个上师者有全面的就去了解。了解以后呢，我们在密法里面有一叫做是言子如我的言子，会观察就是他的这个很多方面，就是他造物的时候很观察，最后他观察完了以后就是没有任何怀疑的直接如我。所以你观察完了以后呢，你可以自己就是去依止善知识。
So it is really important to investigate if the teacher is a qualified teacher before we rely on them, because we can see that many disciples go to receive the teachings or empowerment from some masters without further investigation, and this is very dangerous. So this is just like in the business world, when we sign a contract. Before we sign a contract, each party need to do a lot of research on each party's background or whether they are financial sound to support a project. So relying on a teacher is very similar. We need to look into the behavior and action of a teacher and find out if he's qualified. And find out if the teacher is equipped with techniques or ways to direct us out of samsara and show us the way to liberation. And also, if we want to observe or investigate the teacher in another way, if you are not a Buddhist, you can tell if the teacher can help you to solve some other issues. And just like a bird, building up its nest, before he flies into it, he will first examine if the nest is safe, and after that he will fly into it and lives in the nest. So it is after investigation, we will decide whether we can rely on this teacher or not.
其实这样观察的时候呢，通过上市的一些外面的行为来让观察，就是他内在的智慧和内在的悲心。我看藏文当中，德瓦林的梅西当吉加人的七夕宣求生活罗顿吉这个能怎么到了一起，意思就是说有一个实体性的矫正啊，就是说通过这个外面猫眼呢，就是知道哪个地方是有货，通过那个肺欧，就是那个水欧，然后知道就是那个地方是有贺岁。同样的就是通过一个人的外表来就是观察，就包括他的语言啊，他的行为啊，让观察就是一些甚至就是菩萨的这个智慧和他内在的境界。所以呢我们如果善于观察的话呢，其实很多上师呢就是是不是真正的善知识是依靠这个观察来就是可以知道的。
So by examining or looking to the behaviors or the actions or the Dharma activities from this spiritual teacher, we can know if the teacher is equipped with certain kind of compassion and wisdom and all bodhicitta. So in the sutra of the Ten Ground Sutra, it says that if we can see a smoke from far away, we can tell that there might be a fire over there. And if we see if we see a mammal in the water, we can tell that there should be water around. So by observing the behavior and the actions from the teacher, we should be able to know if the master is a qualified master.
这是第五点。第六一点呢，一知三知识。那么一知三知识的时候呢，刚才观察完了以后你要去一知，但是一知的时候刚开始呢，不要把上师看着佛一样的。虽然在佛经里面佛陀告诉阿难，就是说是你不要痛苦，我将来以三知识的形象来就是饶益你们，就是度化你们。正因为这样呢，很多人不管是什么上师，假上师正上师，只要是上师的话呢，把他当作是真正的什么金刚持佛啊，或者说是文殊菩萨啊，是释迦牟尼佛啊，还有各个的什么所谓的这个法王啊、护法啊，这些都绝对是跟佛一模一样的，无二无别的。但也许他们是因为他们有佛的境界的话，那佛陀也说是将来我会以三智识的方式来显现。但是呢，有些人是确实是不要说佛，连菩萨和阿罗汉的境界都没有。有些人连世间的比较，有一定的比较高标准的这样的智慧和悲心都没有。所以我们刚开始一致的时候把上师当作一个最好的一个时间的老师来对待。
So the next point I want to talk about is to rely on a master. After we examining or observing the spiritual master, and we know if he is a qualified one, we can rely on him or her. In the sutra, even in the sutra, Buddha said to Ananda, Ananda, don't be sad. After I pass into Parinirvana, I will manifest as spiritual teacher to benefit all of you. So from here we can tell that if the master is a qualified master, we can rely on him and we can regard him as the Buddha. However, there are so many fake masters who claim themselves as a self-realized masters or great yogis and things like that. However, we really need to be careful and rely on the right spiritual master, a qualified spiritual masters.
一知三知识过程当中， 刚开始，你可以把它上师当作一个你的朋友、你的老师，或者说你的上一层的这种领导一样来对待。到了一定的时候呢，上师的所作所为，甚至上师显得一些比较不太如法的一些形象的话呢，你可能不会对他产生谢见。我以前1993年的时候去过美国和一些国家，包括加拿大等等。那个时候呢，是川巴仁波切的一些弟子啊，对他的这种信心，确实我就有一种信的感觉，很感动。因为川巴仁波切是87年圆寂的，我们去的时候他的上师已经离开了好多年了，但是呢，他的弟子们就是听到就是川巴仁波切这几个字的时候呢，好像是整个感觉啊，就每一个人听到他的名号的时候，下面有一个很明显的一种触动，就像好像是电就是抨击一样，或者说是就有一种很震撼、很震惊的这种感觉。我记得好像宗萨谦次仁波切也在那个84000问的里面也讲过，就是说是他最佩服的那些弟子啊，就他知道本来是西方人就是特别的聪明，就是他们也可能有时候看到上师的一系列的过失，但不单就是他们不会成为他们的障碍，甚至就更加这个起信心。确实当时我这个书里面说的是就我有同感，就是我看到这些每一个弟子呢，就是对上师的这种真诚性，及上师的这种发脉的就不断的就是去弘扬。包括我就前几年的时候去一些他的中心的时候呢，他们仍然已经上师已经离开了接近30年了，但是呢他们还不断的去弘扬他的教法和他的真理。其实这就是真正的一种医治的方法。对，87年应该，我记得没有错的话说一下。
So here Rinpoche said as a beginner, as a new Buddhist practitioners, the best way is to regard the teacher as your friends or your colleagues or your spiritual teachers. However, after practice for a certain period of time, after you know him, or after your observation, you can regard him as a real spiritual teacher, and you can rely on him. And here I want to share a story. Back in 1993, I went to America. I went to Tsongyong Trungpa Rinpoche's Dharma Center in 1993. And when I was there, it is 6 years after Rinpoche passed away. However, his disciples are still very dedicated, practicing his teaching and practice the Buddha Dharma. And this is very, I was really moved by their disciples, because when they heard Trungpa Rinpoche's name, they are very emotional, and this is just like a electric shock. So I was very moved. And Zongsa Zhongyong Rinpoche also said in his books, 84,000 questions, in his book, he said, Trungpa Rinpoche is a very great master, because a lot of the Western practitioners are very smart, and they are very tactic. So when they practice, they always have a lot of questions, and but they are very dedicated to practice the Buddha Dharma. So I feel very glad that the Buddha Dharma can have such effects in their Dharma center. And the faith from the disciples to Rinpoche is unshakable. So this is very, this is after 30 years after Rinpoche passed away, and the Buddha Dharma can still flourishing in America. This is the real way of relying a guru.
其实西方人对有些人或者说相当一部分人对我们的很多人一知三知是或者说对一个上师的特别的恭敬和崇拜的话呢认为是这是一种个人的崇拜就不太认可甚至呢有各种议论和看法但实际上呢这不是个人的崇拜人到达一定的这种境界甚至这个上师给他的给予是也许时间的很多老师无法满足的这种境界的时候呢那就不由自主的包括这些西方的一些学者啊就科学家啊包括医生啊老师啊很多都是为什么对他们就是个别的上师有如是的恭敬心呢实际上是这里面有很深深的意义所以所谓的西方的一些个人崇拜呢只不过是他们从小的一些法治教育和一些教育的理念和观点不同而导致的应该还要就是有可以共同研究和探讨的余地
So in Western countries, a lot of the Western practitioners have some wrong view on the guru and disciple relationship. And they take this relationship as a personal, respect. And they think this is not the right or healthy relationship. However, Rinpoche said that this is not personal respect because when the disciple have gained some benefits or attained certain realization from the master by practicing the teachings given from the master, their faith on the Buddha Dharma will increase and the faith will be the increasing and become unshakable. So the reason why the Western practitioner has such a view is because the difference of between the difference in the culture and the backgrounds. So for some of the scholars and for some of the scholars, I think there are still areas that we can communicate with each other and build a common ground.
第二个，一知善知识呢，我很佩服那个索加仁波切，他的一些弟子们，因为我去过一些他们的Rupa， 就是他们的一些中心。他们的一些佛教中心也是同样的虽然说叫什么切先还注释但只要提起他的名字的时候很多下面的弟子呢有特别不同的感觉在他们的眼里就把上师比应该超越一些所谓的老师啊或者说是一些他们公司的老板啊等等就所以从这个上面可以看出来包括当时索加仁波切受到一些诽谤的时候呢他的真正的这些弟子呢就应该知道就是上师是对他们的这种怎么样智慧来引导怎么样是利益众生就奉献自己的一切所以有时候佛教当中的观察和一知善知识的方法呢其实它是非常高的一种高度的这么一个智慧来抉择的而并不是一种盲目的信心来抉择的。
So the other example I want to talk about is Sogyal Rinpoche. And I also went to his Dharma center, Rigpa, there are Rigpa in different parts of the world. And unlike Chompa Rinpoche, Sogyal Rinpoche is still a present master who has a great influence. However, the students or his disciples have very strong faith on Rinpoche because of the teachings and transmissions that they receive from Rinpoche. So when the rumor goes around a few decades ago, when people slander Sogyal Rinpoche, his disciples protect the teacher and they didn't leave Sogyal Rinpoche. Instead, they still stay with him and practice the Buddha Dharma. So this is not this kind of guru and disciple relationship is not from personal or emotional from emotional aspects. It's not follow the master blindly, but it's from the wisdom after we observe the master.
第三位呢，就上师如意宝镜里面说，我想很多他的传承弟子的话呢，对他的这种尊重性，或者说对他的感恩性呢，应该来自于他的智慧和价值。包括我本人在内呢，只要听到这个上师如意宝的名称，就是镜面盆座，这个时候呢，我们这个所有的成千上万的传承弟子的话呢，心里有一种不可思议的一种无性的触动，就一种力量。包括再过几天，就我们那个上师如意宝圆寂，就纪念13周年。但是他离开了这么长时间，可是我们对他的这种怀念，对他的感恩，对他的这种相连的话呢，就是可能很多弟子就经常呢，就是在梦中就是见到这个上师的尊严，听到上师的教诲。
The next one I want to talk about is my teacher, His Holiness Jigme Pongso Rinpoche. A lot of the lineage disciples have attained certain realization from His Holiness Jigme Pongso Rinpoche's wisdom. And as for myself, whenever I hear the name of Rinpoche, thousands of disciples will have an intangible. When they hear the name of Rinpoche, thousands of the disciples will have different feelings, and the name of Rinpoche will have an intangible effect. Or intangible force that we can feel, and in a couple of days later it will be Rinpoche's 13 years anniversary. Although Rinpoche has passed away for 13 years, but a lot of the disciple can still dream Rinpoche in his dream. They dream that they still listen to the teaching from Rinpoche, and this is the translation.
Huh? 我刚才讲了，我们那个上师如意宝，包括我们讲一些佛教的比较专业性的。这样的一至三知识的方法降了以后呢，也许我们今天在座的一些学术界的人啊，就阿克达美，就跟那边有一个叫阿克达美，就有些藏族学生那个就读的时候阿克达美，然后有些学术界他们不一定就承认，就觉得我们佛教徒太这个 崇拜就是某个人偶像，实际上不是这样的，就应该是我们有一种很说不清楚的，那为什么一个人就是能影响这么多人，一个人能影响这么多的世代呢？就是其实他这里面有一种不可思议的这种力量。以前讲到米拉瑞巴听到马巴罗扎的时候呢，名号的时候，就是他特别有一种不可思议的这种感触啊。我自己的是说不上这样的，这样说很惭愧的。但是我原来没有出家的时候，我在学校里面的时候，我们有一个张文老师，他经常抽一根烟，然后就在上课的时候边抽烟，就是然后边拉着那个茶杯，就是喝茶，还戴着一个狐狸帽，然后，但是他教的非常好的，就是他又一次在课堂上提过，说现在的有些所谓的上师是我不太承认，但据说在色达的一个山沟里面，就叫堪布吉米盆索，他是经常跟五六十个出家人呢讲解说法，我非常佩服他。当时听到他的名号的时候呢，上师如意宝的名号的时候呢，的确是我可能现在说，也许你们不一定相信，就是有特别大的一种震撼，就是怎么讲，就是当时心里面的那种，就像好像就怎么说啊，就是在电脑里面那种咯当，就是怎么说啊，就有一种感觉。那后来我来到佛学院的时候呢，我刚好23岁，那个时候什么都不懂，就满腹都是一些傲慢心，这个烦恼，还自己什么都不懂，现在觉得很惭愧。但是就依着善知识，第一次见到这个上师，但后来呢，就是不断的就给一些有形无形的智慧。虽然我现在也是非常普普通通的人，但是呢，在人生当中，人和人也是没有办法就是与这个上师这个相提并论。他给予的这种智慧和他给予的力量的话呢，也许世界上所有的包括父母在内，就是不一定给我给予。
So we talk about we just talked about the relationship between the guru and disciple. A lot of people from the academic circle, they may not share the same view, and they still think that we follow the teacher blindly, and it's a blind faith. However, we need to think why a person can have such a great influence.There must be an intangible, unbelievable force behind it. I can't say that we all know that the guru and relationship between Milarepa and Marpa. I want to share a story. When I was at school, there was a teacher who always smoked cigarette in his mouth.And he told us that there are many teachers in Tibetan area. However, a lot of the teachers, I don't admire some of them, but I really admire His Holiness Jigme Pongtor Rinpoche, and he teaches his disciples. There are 50 to 60 disciples that he taught. So for myself, whenever I hear the name of my teacher, there is a feeling that I can't express use any words. This is not something that I can or express out of words. So when I came to Laronga at my early 20s, I was a person who were arrogant and full of many afflictions. However, by relying on His Holiness Jigme Pongtor Rinpoche, I have changed a lot. I have gained wisdom by learn his teachings. So although now I'm still an ordinary person, but the blessing or the effects or the influence His Holiness Jingmei Pongchun Rinpoche on me is unbelievable and cannot be expressed use any words.
现在我们的时间马上已经就圆满了。当然这个我想讲到是最后一个第七点呢，就获得上师的智慧。获得上师的智慧呢有两种途径，就是第一种呢如理如是的去医治，系统的学习，就按次第的去依照奉行，就跟着上师的这个要求去学习一些经论啊知识啊，就是这样的。还有一种呢就是通过一些气道，一些恭敬心，有一些诚实，就那样来就是获得上师的这种遗传加持。也就是说上师相续当中的所有的这些功德啊，就是远远不远远本本一字不落的全部就我们所谓的这个满瓶倾泻般的就是融入自己的相续，获得上师的这种遗传加持，或者说是上师的真正的色泽和传承，就可以这样讲。所以当然这个呢可能还有一些属上师瑜伽啊，还有一些经常就是观修啊，我都经常念那个上师如意宝的祈祷文啊，祈祷文当中呢就专门有几个净眉喷错的字，我就每次念到这里的时候呢，自己感觉到任何注意都可能没办法代替，就是它有更强的一些力量。包括诸路也好，就是在任何时候念这个祈祷文的时候呢，其实祈祷文给我带来的不管是前出文化维远也好，人事心性也好，很多方面呢就无法用语言来形容。这就是获得了上师加持的。
So our teaching is almost come to a conclusion, and here I want to talk about in all the there are different ways to gain the blessing or the wisdom from our lineage masters. We can rely on the master wholeheartedly. That's one way, and we can also studying the Buddha Dharma stage by stage, and do what the master tells us, and also we can pray to the masters and pay great respects to them, or do things for the masters, and if we are able to do all these things, the merits from the great masters. We will be gaining the merits from the masters. This is just like pouring the full bottle of water into the vase without any drippings. So we can there are another way to gain the wisdom from the masters. Such as practicing guru yoga or contemplate on the merits of our lineage masters. So for me, whenever I do things, I will chant the prayer of Jigme Pongchun Rinpoche, and this is something that that is really important to me, and nothing can replace. Can replace the importance of it. So by chanting the prayers, we can it help us to realize the nature of our mind, or it help us to eliminate the difficulties on our path to liberation. So practice guru yoga are very important, and we can also use other ways to gain the benefits and the wisdom from the masters.
般若经和还有相关专论里面有一种叫做是内散之识，实际上降到自己的包括真念呐、悲心呐、心性呐，就是这些叫做是内散之识。我们这里呢，也按照密宗的一些说法，就把自己的心跟上师的智慧融入一体，修成这样的境界的话呢，这叫做是，自己的这种觉悟觉性，就是善知识，觉性善知识。那么，获得了上师的所有的这种加持，对自己的心跟上师的智慧无二无别的时候呢，其实随心所欲的可以利益这个无量无边的众生。我这个一知三知识的报就课呢就算圆满，好像时间稍微超了一点，但是呢古人语中叫做是存金难昧存光阴，是吧？但是我还是比这个更有价值的一些金子给你们，就所以你们时间稍微就自己也怎么说，你说吧。
The last parts from Rinpoche just said that there are three spiritual masters. The first one is the outer spiritual masters that we have talked about, and there are also inner spiritual masters or friends, which are by practicing the teachings from the teacher, we can attain certain realization, whether it be the realization of compassion or the realization of bodhicitta. And in tantric tradition the spiritual master means that the wisdom resolve into the nature of mind, and there is and our mind and the wisdom of a teacher has no distinctive difference.
其实我瞎说的，不是。那我们这样，我这个金子经呢，就前一段时间翻译的，里面内容很简单，就是讲了这个佛陀呢，就是即孤独园的时候，阿难尊者的一个对话，就是问那个菩提心是怎么修。那么菩提心呢，就自性清净，就是像镜子一样的。然后虽然是镜子，但是他供讲就是依靠种种这个殊胜的装饰品都可以做。就然后佛陀后来把这个道理呢，就是以寄送的方式说，这个菩提心的自性是清净的，然后精勤呢就是自他而立。就精勤自他而立，然后观修呢就是无始的空性，心界什么呢，就是心界这个智慧印，就是生起智慧的印，就是这么一个道理。意思就是说呢，生意菩提心是像金子一样，就永远没有任何改变的一个清净的，就是道理，就是这是生意菩提心。实殊菩提心呢，原佛果的智慧，就是也就是我们说原这个就智慧圆菩提，就智慧圆菩提呢，就是观这个空性啊，就观空性，然后获得对无生的这种道理升起这个心界的时候，就是产生这个佛陀的智慧。然后用悲心来观这个无量的众生的话呢，自他都可以从轮回当中获得解脱，就是所以用悲心来愿众生，就是我的这个解释的话呢，实际上是这个金子经里面就降到了这个生意菩提心和世俗菩提心。那么今天呢也是特殊的日子，这个我们全球上的很多的人呢，就今天这个作为新年的开始，那么新年的开始当中呢，我就这么一个特别珍贵的金子呢，就是免费的给你们作为新年礼物，谢谢你们。
So next, Rinpoche is going to give the oral transmission of the Noble Gold-like Mahayana Sutra. And basically, this sutra is a conversation between... a conversation between Buddha himself and Ananda. So Ananda asked Buddha how to practice the bodhicitta. And the Buddha said, bodhicitta has two aspects. One is the absolute bodhicitta, and the other one is conventional bodhicitta. So the ultimate bodhicitta is as pure as gold, and it's pure in nature, just like gold. And in the conventional bodhicitta, there are also two aspects. The first aspect is to gain the wisdom. To gain the wisdom through emptiness. The other aspect is to practice compassion to benefit all the sentient beings. So there are two aspects of this bodhicitta. So on this special day, on the first day of 2017, I want to give this oral transmission to all of you, and it's very precious, and it's valuable than gold or anything, and it's for free. So I hope all of you will gain some benefits through it.
Bhagba Sirjim Dojisha, Tabba Chimbum do Jagarkata Arias Bernasa Maha Yana Namasa Cha Urkutan, Bhagba Sirjim Dojisha, Tabba Chimbum do Sanjidam Shansibsan Watamchala Shamsar Lo under Kutoka Tupati Yusina Chundan de Jar Jashiki, some woman Zijinji Kangaravana Jidi, Tse, Chundan de La Setan Dambakanka under Kitchi Sorto, Chundan de Shansibji Sim, Chester of Tower of Jew, Chundan de Gipkazara, Setan Dambakangao, Shansibji Sim, Sirdan, Ranjan Tower, Nipper of Tower of Jew, Sergi Ranjan, number of Tabar, Tar, Shansibji Sim Ranjanji, number of Tabar Nesu. Garrix said love zo, shaped of tata per sheet and sir Ramjan Mangerata, Shanship Simla, Yondon Chaparvas Nazo, Yang, Tuntam Bar, Shanship Gisimla, Mayu, Ramjan Manger Yushiro, Tinichundan Digi, Tsis Chapi Quatsarva, Shanship Semir Nabrata, Dodan Janji, Tonla Son, Woman Owen Yetogum, Sheru Chipi Dela Mo, Chundan Digi, Tirkichi Quatsar, Tedan Damba Kungawa, Tamchetan Dambin Kurt Dedan, Hadan, Madan, Hamayan. Jazadam Chibu, Jitin Yerandi, Jundin de Yosombala, Mumber Todo, Papa Sirgim Dojisha, Taba Chimbum Dorzo. So,
thank you so much, Rinpoche, for giving us such a wonderful teaching and precious transmission on the first day of 2017. It is so true that it's the Guru who guided us on the spiritual path. It is a Guru who awakens us the wisdom and compassion within ourselves. It is the Guru who points out the nature of our mind and show us the true meaning of life. Just like the sutra says, may the precious gold-like bodhicitta, the mind of awakening, arise in the heart of each of us. Thanks again, Kampo Rinpoche, and Happy New Year to all of you.非常感谢仁波切在新年的第一天给我们精彩的开示以及珍贵的传承。在佛法修持的这条道路上，善知识是至关重要的引路人，是善知识开启了我们内在的智慧与慈悲，是善知识令我们悟入新的本性，是善知识教我们契入生命的真谛。
祈愿佛经中所说，在新的一年，每个人的心中都能够升起一颗金子般的菩提心。再次感谢仁波切，再次祝大家新年快乐。愿我 出神力，给予真法，具有如理修持之自由。
愿我能令上师生欢喜，日日夜夜之中行正法。
愿我无烦后修净化一毕生，越过三有之大海。
至生生世世中佛得居住，即得至善居。
愿我出生离机遇真法，具有如理修持之自由。
愿我能令上师生欢喜，日日夜夜之中行正法。好修净化一毕生，越过三有四大海。愿我能为众生传妙法，
成
正觉。